Hello, my dear. Welcome back to my class. Sir Ham Chin, channel of NCRT Maths 11 feet, NCRT Maths. Maths and Physics, Tanya channel. Okay, here it goes. So we have finished the introduction part of trigonometric function. There was trigonometric function. So I write here trigonometric function in short. Okay, trigonometric function in short. As of now, we have finished all the introduction part. Okay, fine. So this is my earnest request to you, all of you, is that please go through the introduction part. Okay, go through the introduction part, especially introduction for exercise 3.3. That rule of sign is very important. Okay, so if you cannot remember, that means you cannot proceed further, though you can do so. In between you will get stuck. So avoid that confusion. Okay, this is my request to go through the video. Okay, if you cannot understand, so please pause the video and watch it again and again. Okay, please. So today in this class we'll be solving the numerical problems. Okay, one after another, please. Okay, and also I'm requesting all of you to memorize all those formulas and all. Okay, so first of all, the question number one. So I don't want to write the question, so you have the book. Okay, here prove that number one. Okay, so we have to prove the following. Okay, question number one, that is prove that. Okay, number one, that is sine square pi by 6 plus cos square of pi by 3 minus 10 square of pi by 4 equals minus 1 by 2. Okay, we have to prove that this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Okay, to prove this, okay, so just we have to put the value. Again, you have to remember what the values of the trigonometric function. Okay, then only it would be possible for you to work out this problem. Correct. So after putting the value, we'll be calculating. Okay, and then we have to prove that left hand side equal to right hand side, that is minus 1 by 2. Okay, we must get this. Okay, here it goes. Okay, first of all, let us write left hand side. What is the left hand side? Sine square of pi by 6 plus cos square of pi by 3 minus 10 square of pi by 4. Okay, this is the what? Left hand side. Okay, let us put the value. Sine square, that is pi equal to what? Pi equal to 180 degree. Okay, pi equal to 180 degree. If it is pi by 6, that means it will be 6, pi by 6, so it will be 30, right? Okay, so if you have confusion, you put like this, okay, you calculate like this. So sine 30 degree, what is the value? So that is, so it is sine square, that will be what? Sine square pi by 6, that means 30, that equals to 30 degree, that is pi by 6, whose value is what? 1 by 2, correct? So 1 by 2. So whose value? Sine. So what is there? Square is there. Plus, it will be pi by 3. Pi by 3 equal to how much? So we have to consider the value of what? We have to consider the value of pi by 3. That is 60 degree. Yes or no? That will be 60 degree. Okay. I am telling you, as sine increases from 0 to 1 and cos decreases from 1 to 0. Correct? 1 to 0. Okay? 1 to 0. Okay? It is increasing. So it is decreasing. Right? So what is that? Pi by 3. What is the value of pi by 3? Cos pi by 3, there will be, so it is 60 degree. That means cos 60 degree, right? Cos 60 degree. Cos 60 degree equals to how much? So 1 by 2. Okay, there is 1 by 2 whole square minus 10 square. So you know, my dear, at 10 square, 10, as you know that 10 theta equal to what? 10 theta equal to sine theta by cos theta. Then if we consider 10 45 degree, then you consider this also 45 degree, sine 45 degree. Okay, that means it will be cos 45 degree. Okay, that equals what? Sine 45 and cos 45. So there is equal 1 by under root of 2, and then here also 1 by under root of 2. You have to remember at 45 degree. So sine and cos is equal to each other. If sine and cos equal to each other, and if we take the what, 10 theta equal to sine theta, is given by sine theta by cos theta, then we get 1. Okay, so it will be 1. So it is there square? Yes, 1 square. Okay, fine, next. So what is that? Half square means what? 1 by 4 plus here also 1 by 4 minus square of 1 is 1. Then the LCM will be 4, so it will be 1 plus 1 and then minus 1. Okay, then let us, so it is 2 by 4, again take the LCM, 4 into 1 minus 4. So this gives equal what? Minus 2 by 4. So we got the answer minus 1 by 2, correct? 2 1 the 2, 2 2 the 4. Okay, that means left hand side equal to right hand side. So we have proved it. Second one. Okay, before Maria, before having it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, fine. Okay, I'm rubbing it. Now, Roman number 2, that is 2 sine square of, so you write 2 sine square of pi by 6 minus plus cosec square of 7 pi upon 6 minus it is not minus into okay it is into cos square of 5 by 3, that equals to 3 by 2. We have to prove this. Okay, this is the left hand side. Let us write left hand side equal to what? Left hand side equal to 2 sine square pi by 6 plus cosec square 7 pi by 6 into cos square pi by 3. Okay, this is the left hand side. So my dear, here sine square of pi by 6, let us put the value directly, 2 sine square. So what is the value of pi by 6 means what? Sine pi by 6, there is what? 180 by 6, that means what? 30. So it will be half of square plus. So here one thing is, so what is that? So we have to break into part. Okay, it will be plus or minus. Let me say, suppose if we break 3 pi by 2, okay, then it will be what? Then it will be pi plus pi by 2. It will be like this. So take the LCM, 2 pi plus pi. So it will be 3 pi by 2. In the same way, so we can break this, right? How to break this? 7 pi. That means pi plus pi by 6. That gives equal to what? That is 6 pi, 6 into pi, 6 pi plus pi. So that gives equal to what? 7 pi by 6. 7 pi upon 6. So it will be what? 7 pi plus pi by 6. Okay? You remember this. Okay? Into cos square pi by 3. Cos pi by 3, there is 60 degree. There is half of square. Yes or no? So cos, what is that? Cos, it will be 60 degree. At cos 60 degree, that the value is what? 1 by 2. So if it is what cos square, then it will be square. Now it will be how much? 2 into 1 by 4 plus cosec square. Okay? Cosec square pi by 6. Okay. So it is what? If sine equal to what? Sine 30 equal to, that means 1 by 2. And cosec, that means pi by 6, it will be 30, right? That means it will be how much? It will be cosec. Let us put the value directly. Cosec square, pi by 6 equal to what? That means in this case, cosec 30 will be what? 1 upon, so cosec is what? Cosec is just a reciprocal of 1 upon sine, right? So it will be sine 30. It will be sine 30, that means it will be what? 1 upon 1 by 2. That means 1 cancel, so it will be 2 only, right? So it will be 2. So it will be 2 square into here 1 by 4, correct? Okay, fine. So 2 to the 4, okay? And here, okay, 1 by 2 plus 4 into 4, 1 by 4. We are supposed to get 3 by 2, right? You are supposed to get 3 by 2. Yes, it's correct only. So this one cancel, what is left? 1 left. So 1 upon 2 plus 1. Take the LCM, so LCM is 2, and then multiply this, cross multiply, so 2 1s are 2, plus, so here is 1, so 1, so 3 by 2, that gives you what? Right hand side. Fine. So my dear, before wrapping it, please pause the video and write it down, please. And then next, third one. Okay, third one is 4 square pi by 6. 4 square pi by 6 plus cosec, okay, cosec, this is cosec, cosec how much? 5 pi by 6 plus 3 10 square. Plus 3 10 square, that is 10 square of pi by 6 equals to 36. So this is the left hand side, this part. 4 square pi by 6 plus cosec 5 pi by 6 plus 3 10 square pi by 6. This is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. This is the left hand side and this is the right hand side, correct? So we have to prove on putting the value. After calculating, we must get equal to 6. Then we can prove that, what is again? Hence, we can prove that left hand side equal to right hand side. Okay, fine. I'm rubbing this part. Okay, fine. Next, what is that? Let me write here. Left hand side. What is left hand side? Left hand side equal to cot square of pi by 6 plus cosec, that is 5 pi by 6 plus 3 tan square
pi by 6. Here what we can write? Cot square pi by 6. That means it will be what? Pi by 6. Yes or no? Pi. So it will be 180 upon this one, 6. So it will be 30. That means 30, right? So at 30, how much it will be? Let us consider sine 30 and sine 30 and cos 30, because cos 30, cos is what? Just we are considering the question relation of cot. Okay, so if we consider cot 30, then sine cos 30 by sine 30. Okay, so as you know that sine 30 is what? 1 upon half, and cos 30 will be how much? How much it will be? How much? It will be root 3 by 2. Okay, root 3 by 2 upon 2 into 2 by 1. That means 2 to cancel, so root 3. Okay, here by root 3, so what is there? Square is there. Square is there. So put square plus cosec of pi by 6. Okay, how to get? So it is less. Yes or no? So it will be pi minus how much? Pi minus okay, pi by 6. That means 6 pi minus pi, you will have 5 pi. Okay, plus 3 into 10 square pi by 6. So it will be 10 30. Okay, at 30 it will be 1 upon under root 2 whole square. Okay, check it. Okay, whether it is correct or not. So if you check there in your textbook, so you get, so 10 30 equal to what? 1 by under root 3. So what is the square is there? So put the square. So it will be root 3 whole square. So it will be 3. That means root 3 into what? We have learned in class 10. So root 3 into root 3 is given by root 3 only. Plus, it will be how much? Cosec of pi by 6, right? Plus, it will be how much? 3 into 1 square. Square of 1 is 1. And root 3 into root 3, there is 3. Okay, this one and this one cancel. Then what is left? Cosec of pi by 6. That means cosec pi by 6 is what? So it will be 2, right? It will be 2. That means sine 30 equal to what? Sine 30 equal to 1 by 2. That means cosec 30 will be how much? Cosec 30, that is given by 1 upon sine 30. Sine 30 is how much? 1 upon 1 by 2. So it will be how much? 1 into 2 by 1. So it will be 2. Okay, 2 plus, it will be how much? 1. Okay, we have already got the answer. So it equals to what? 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. Okay, that equals to what? Right hand side. Okay, my dear, before rubbing it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, room number 4. What is that room number 4? Okay, Roman number 4 I have left for you. Okay, just put the value, go accordingly. So first one, 2 sine square 3 pi by 4. So subtract it. Okay, so it will be like this. Okay, pi minus pi by 4. So 4 pi, 4 into 5, 4 pi, 4 pi minus pi. That will be what? 3 pi by 4. Correct? It will be like this. And then next one. Okay, then next one no need to write. Okay. Then come to that okay, fine, next one. This is trigonometric function, okay? This is trigonometric function. So next one, 5, 1,
Okay, that is sine 45. Sorry, sine 75 degree. Okay, first of all, we have to break this. Okay, we have to break this. Like it will be x minus y, like a minus b, something like this. Okay, we break into parts, right? So it will be what? Sine of, what is that? 45 degree plus 30 degree, correct? So 45 plus 30 equal to 75, right? So we got one formula, that is what? Sine of x plus y, that gives equal to what? Sine of x and a cos of y, right? Minus or plus? Minus, right? Or plus? Yeah, plus. So cos x into sine y. So it is like this. Okay? That means, so it will come to x part and this one will come into y part. Correct? Okay, fine. Now let us put. So you remember this is a formula. Okay? This is a formula for number one, Roman number one. And we can write here, let me write here, sine 45 degree into cos 30 degree plus, okay, according to this, cos, this is the 45 degree and this is the 30 degree, okay? So here it will come what? 45 and here it will come 30. So here 45 and here 30. Okay, fine. So cos of 45 degree into sine of 30 degree. Okay, sine 45 degree equal to how much? That is 1 upon root 2. And then cos 30, cos 30 will be how much? Root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 plus cos 45, there is 1 upon root 2, right? And then sine 30, that is 1 by 2. Okay, fine. So we cannot reduce it, right? So take LCM. LCM is what? 2 into root 2. So it will be 1 into root 3, root 3. Plus, it will be the same. It will be the same. Root 2, so 1 into 1, 1. So what we can do now? So it is in the form of what? Like fraction. Okay, what is called like fraction? Like fraction is nothing but the fraction who have the same denominator. That's the like fraction. So it will be, if it is same, then it will be 2 into under root 2. So it will be root 3 plus 1. Correct? Now what we can do is that we have to find a value. Let us rationalize the denominator. Okay? Let us rationalize the denominator. If we rationalize the denominator, it will be then how much? So it will multiply by 2 into under root 2 and then 2 into under root 2. We rationalize in this way, right? So then it will be what? 2 into under root 2 into root 3 plus 1, correct? And then it will be how much? That gives equal to what? 2 into 2, 4. Okay, root 2 into root 2, that gives equal to what? 2. And then it will be 2 into under root 2 into root 3 plus 1. So can we cancel 1 here? Yes, we can cancel. So our answer is root 3 plus 1 by 4. Root 3 under root 2 into root 3 plus 1 by 4. Okay? Under root 3 plus 1 upon 4. Okay? This is the value. This is the answer. Okay? Okay, my dear, before rubbing it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, fine. I'm rubbing. Second part. So we have to break into this part. 10, 15 degree. Of course, we have to subtract it, yes or no? So 45 degree minus 30. That gives equal to what? It will be 10, okay? It will be 10. 10, 45 45 minus 30. That gives equal to what? 15. Right? I'm rubbing this part. Okay. Left hand side. Oh, we have to find a value, right? So the tan of 15 degree equals to, let us break into parts. Okay, there will be 45 degree minus, we have to obtain. Okay, either adding or subtracting, we must get equal to 15 degree, but on adding, it is not possible, right? Okay, so it will be proceeding towards infinity, right? So it will be 45 degree minus 30. Okay, fine. Okay, now, are you remembering the formula? There is tan of x minus y. Okay, we have learned in the introduction part. Yes or no? We have learned in the introduction part. Correct? Okay, fine. So it was how much? It will be tan x minus tan y upon 1 minus 10x and then 10y. 10x and then 10y. This is the formula. Okay? So this is the what? X part and this is the y part. Correct? Okay. That means then we can write. So it will be what? Applying that formula, 10x. 10 in x part. So this is x and this is y. Okay? It will be 10, 45. And then here will be what? 10, 30 degree. So it will be what? 1 plus, okay, this is plus. 1 plus 10, 45 into 10, 30. Correct? Now let us replace by its value. 10, 45 degree equal to how much? It is 1, okay? If we consider at 45 degree, okay, sine equal to cos, okay, there is equal to 1 by root 2. So, as you know that tan theta equal to what? There is sine theta upon cos theta, right? So, if the value is same, that means it will be 1 by under root 2, and also it will be 1 by under root 2. So, it will be cut. What is that? 1. Okay? Let us continue with this question number 6. So question here, from question number 6 to question number 25, the question is asking us to prove the following given question, correct? Okay, here it is given, question number 6, so cos of 5 by 4 minus x into cos of 5 by 4 minus y, and then minus sine of 5 by 4 minus x, and then sine of 5 by 4 minus y, okay? Equals what? Sine of x plus y. So we have to prove, like, what is that? This left hand side, okay, must be equal to right hand side, right? So let us consider that this is A and this is B part, and this is A part and this is B part, okay? We have learned there is that cos of x plus y. So since x is given, so we are considering A plus B, okay? A plus, so now, what is that? This cos of A plus B equals what? Cosine cos B minus sine of sine A to sine B. That is what? CD or rule. And then cos of A minus B equals what? Cosine to cos B plus sine A to sine B. That's what we have learned in the introduction part, right? Okay. So it is CD or rule. So what is the CD or rule? That means CD of full form. CD of full form is what? Cos doublet opposite sine. Now you see cos here in the first case, so when it is positive, now it is negative. When it is negative, then it is positive. You have to remember like that. Okay, so the rest of the things are the same. Okay, rest it is all same, right? Okay, let me write the left hand side. Okay, this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Okay, left hand side equal to what? There is cos of 5 by 4 minus x cos of pi by 4 minus y minus sine of what? Pi by 4 minus x into sine of what? That is pi by 4 minus y, correct? have to do. Okay, now we have to write in this form. Okay, now we have to write in this form. Correct. Then cos of what? Now this one is, this given equation is in this form, right? In this form. Now we have to write in this form, right? Okay. Then it will become what? Cos of pi by 4 minus x. Okay. And then next what will come? What will come? And next one, what will come? Thank you, my dear. Next, what will come? Next, what will come? There will be plus. So this is plus, yes or no? This is plus. So we have finished this part, yes or no? In B part, A part, pi by 4 minus x, correct? In B part, what is there? There is pi by 4 minus y. Yeah? It is the same. Right, so it will be plus y plus, because this is plus, right? So it will be what? That is pi by 4 minus y. Okay, find cos of this will be what? Now let us remove the bracket. Pi by 4 minus x plus, it will be what? Pi by 4 minus y, correct? Okay, now let us this, let us rearrange. Pi by 4 is plus pi by 4 minus x minus y, right? Is pi by 4 plus pi by 4, that means what is that? It is something like 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. Yeah, it is 1 by 4 only. So it is a like fraction. So it will be, if it is like fraction, the denominator will remain the same. That will be considered as the LCM. So 4, so 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, then 2 by 4, so 2 1s are 2. And then put that 4. So what is that? 4 by 2. So you know how much? Okay, fine. Now, cos of it will be how much? 2 pi by 4 minus x minus y. Right? Then it gives you equal to what? So 2 by 4. That is 2. So what is that? Pi by 2. Now what we can do? We can close this pi bracket. Okay, x plus y. So on closing pi bracket, so minus will turn into plus, right? Okay, on the moment bracket, we are going to get the same, right? So what is that now? So it is this pi by 2. Okay, as we have learned that there in the introduction part, hopefully in introduction part 1, we have learned that on the x-axis, sine function does not change. Okay, when the sine function is to change on y axis, right? On x again, I repeat the same. On x axis, sine what is that? Trigonometric function does not change. Okay, trigonometric function does not change where? On x axis. But on the other hand, trigonometric function change where? On y axis. Okay, how does change take place? That means what is that? Sine to cos, and then what is that? Cos to sine, cos to sine, then to what? Cos, and then sec to what? Sec to cosec. Okay, that's what we have learned. Okay, we have learned is where in the introduction part. Now, okay, pi by 2, where pi by 2 is lying? Let us represent with the help of the diagram. Okay, this is pi by 2. Okay, this is pi by 2, and it is 0, 2 pi, and this is first quadrant, this is second, and this is pi, and then this is third, and this is 4, right? So it is 3 pi by 2, correct? Okay, fine. So function is to change, and function does not change at this place, okay? It remains the same. Okay, this part is all positive, right? This part is all positive. But here, on y-axis, okay? On y-axis, sine function. That means the trigonometric function is to change. From where to where? From sine to cos, and cos to sine, then to cos, sec to cosec. Okay? It's like that. Correct? Okay, fine. Now,
So at pi by 2, okay, pi by 2, at pi by 2, okay, when sine increases from where to where? From 0 to 1, that means from 0 to degree to 90 degree, that means cos function, value of cos decreases from 0 to 1, right? Sorry, 1 to 0. So sine increases from 0 to 1, and then on the other hand, cos, value of cos decreases from 1 to 0. Okay, 1 to 0. So where is 0? At 90 degree. Yes or no? This is the place of 90 degree. Correct? This is the place of 90 degree. At 90 degree, so cos 90 degree equals to 0. Okay? Cos 90 degree equal to 0. So it will be 0, right? Okay, fine. My dear, before running it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, fine. I'm running this part. And then here, as I told you that, what is that? Cos trigonometric function, okay, changes where on y-axis. Since it is what cos, it cos is changing at pi by 2, that means at 90 degree. That means it will change into what? Sine. Okay? It will be changing to sine. So, what is that? Sine of x plus 1, which is our answer. That means we have already right hand side. So this part is not done. Okay? So it will be 0. Okay? It will be 0. Next question. What is the next question? That is question number 7. What is that 7? Tan of pi by 4 plus x upon tan of pi by 4 minus x. That gives you what? 1 plus tan x upon 1 plus 1 minus I think 1 minus tan x 1 minus tan x whole square. Okay, this is the left hand side. Okay, this is the right hand side. So what we have to prove? This left hand side must be equal to right hand side. We have to prove in here. Okay, here it goes. Solution. So left hand side equals what? Tan of pi by 4 plus x upon tan of pi by 4 minus x. That means again we have to use the identity. What identity? Tan of x plus y. That gives equal what? That gives equal what? Tan of, and then tan of x minus y. Okay? Here also what used to be opposite? The sign used to be opposite. Sign of what? Sign of what? Numerator and the denominator. Okay? Numerator and the denominator. So it will be what? Tan of x plus y, that gives equal to what? Tan x minus tan y. Okay, when it is positive, then it is negative, then the numerator will be positive. Tan x into tan y. So here tan x, here it is, here it is what? Positive, sorry, negative. If it is negative, and it will be positive. Tan x plus tan y, and here 1 minus tan x into tan y. Correct? Okay, fine. Let us prove. Okay, now this tan of pi by 4 plus x, okay, let us replace, okay, let us replace. So this is the x part, okay, this is x and this is y part, okay, this is x part and this is y part, correct? So it will be tan of what? Tan of pi by 4 minus tan of
correct, upon what? One plus ten of pi by 4 into 10x. Okay, so second case, like 10 minus y, 10 of x minus y, that is what? That is what? 10x plus 10y, 10 of pi by 4, sorry. Pi by 4 plus 10 of what? 10 of x. 10 of x upon 1 minus 10 of pi by 4 into 10x. Correct? Let me continue from here. Here, you know something, pi by 4. Okay? When sine pi by 4 means what? So it is what? 45 degree, right? That means sine 45 degree and the cos 45 degree, right? Okay, as we know that. What is that? 10 of what? Sine 10 theta equal to sine 10 theta equal to what? Sine theta upon cos theta. That means if we consider 10 45 degree, that means it will be sine 45 degree. Okay, then it will be cos 45 degree, correct? So it will be what? It will be 1 by root 2 upon 1 by root 2. Okay, so it will be cancel. Okay, it will be cancel, right? So 10 45 degree, that means 10 pi by 4 means what? Means what? Means 1. Okay, it is answer. So it will be 1. Correct? So it will be 1 plus 10x by 1 minus 10x whole square. Let me check one thing, okay? Here I'll be consistent, okay? Plus, so it will be minus, okay? So it is minus and it is plus. I just correct it. Plus, here it is minus, here it is minus, here it is plus. Okay, now it is coming out. So it will be 1 plus 10x. Is 10 pi by 4 equals to what? 1 into 10x, correct? And then here 10 by 1, 10 of pi by 4, that is 1 minus 10x upon 1 plus what? 1 plus 10 pi by 4, that is 1 into 10x. That means equal to what? Gives equal to what? So it will be 1 plus 10x, 1 minus 1 into 10x. So it will be 1 minus 10x, correct? And then let us reverse this, okay? So it will be what? 1 plus 1 into 10x, 10x. Okay? And then 1 minus 10x. So what is this? 1 minus 10x whole square. And then here also 1 plus 10 into 1 plus 10x. Okay, that means a plus b into a plus b equals what? A plus b whole square, right? Correct, in this form. Likewise, a minus b to a minus b whole square. So it will be what? 1 plus 10x whole square. That means both the numerator and the denominator have what? Square. So I'm writing this part here, okay? We can make it whole square. Why we can make it whole square? Because both numerator and the denominator have what? Have square. So 1 minus 10x, okay, whole square. Done. So equal to right hand side. Fine. Okay.
So my name, before rubbing it, please pause the video and write it down, please.
Next question. That is question number eight. What it is? Cos of sine of pi minus x and then cos of pi by 2 plus x. That gives equal to what? Cot square x. Okay, that gives equal to cot square x. Correct. Here let us write left hand side is what? So cos of pi plus x, okay, into cos of what? Minus x. Okay, so sine of pi minus x into cos of pi by 2 plus x.
Okay, fine. Here we need to know one thing. What is that, you know? Okay, fine. Okay, so
it is 0 and this is pi by 2 first quadrant and this is second quadrant, and then what it is talking about? Pi plus x, right? Pi plus x. So this is the third quadrant and then this is what? Fourth quadrant. Okay, this is all minus minus, this is plus and minus, and this is all positive. Okay, all positive, and then this is what? Minus and plus. So we are considering with the word cos x and cos sine x, right? Sine x and cos x. So here, so it is what? Pi plus x. Okay, pi plus x is lying where? So this is the pi plus x, right? Where it is? So it is pi, and then what is that? Up to here, from here to here, from here to here, it is what? Pi by 2, from here to here, pi by 2. That means what? Pi by 2 plus pi by 2? This quadrant equal to pi by 2, this quadrant also equal to pi by 2. Pi by 2 plus pi by 2, that gives equal to what? Pi, correct? So here, so it is increasing, right? It is increasing. So it is a pi plus x. Okay, Now you see the sign, so it is minus. So what is given here? Cos. Okay, cos it will be minus. Okay, cos will be minus. Correct? Cos will be minus. Understood? Cos will be minus. Why minus? Because it is where? 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 In the third quadrant, so it is minus. So it will be minus. Okay, let me write here. Cos pi plus x. So we have to take this only, right? So it will be minus cos x. And then, as we have learned in the introduction part, the first formula, okay? The first formula, yeah. So first we have got what? 2n pi plus x. We have got like this sign equal to what? So it will be sin x, right? So 2, what is the cos of 2n pi? What we have got? Plus x equal to what? Cos x, right? And the second formula, secondly we have got that cos of minus x is given by what? Positive x. And then sin of minus x is given by what? Minus sin x. Correct? Okay, fine. So it is cos of minus x. So we are going to take this formula. So it will be cos x. Correct? Okay, fine. Now sin pi minus x. What is sin pi minus x? So this is the what? This is pi. Okay? So it is what? This part is what? Less than pi, right? So this part is less than pi. Correct? So this will be what? Pi minus x. Okay? Pi minus x. So what is that? This is, this negative is what? Cos. And this positive is what? Sin. Okay? If sin is positive, then sin of pi minus x also positive. So it will be sin x. Correct? It will be sin x. And then cos pi by 2. Okay, cos pi by 2. Cos pi by. So where on which axis? On y axis. Okay, on which axis? On y axis. As I told you that this is x axis and this is 2 pi. Okay, as I told you that this is the x axis and x axis on x axis function. What is that? Trigonometric function does not change. Okay, trigonometric function does not change where on x axis. At this axis, okay, and at this axis on y axis, okay, that means at pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, okay, trigonometric function changes. Trigonometric function changes, right? So what is the place of, so this is what, this part is what, pi by 2 minus x, this part, so this is what, this part is what, pi by 2, that means more than pi by 2, plus x, okay. Correct? So on which axis it is lying? On which axis? Okay, so it is what, cos of pi by 2? If it is lying on what is that, on y axis, that means the cos will change into what? Cos will change into sin x. Right? Sin x. And what is cos here? Cos is negative. So sin will be negative. Okay? That means it will be sin x. Okay? So minus minus cancel. Okay? Cos x into cos x. What? Cos square x. Sin x into sin x. Sin square x. So this is what? That gives what? Cos square x. This is the what question relation. That's what we have proved. Okay? Equals to right hand side. Okay, my dear, I hope you understood. Okay, before rubbing it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, my dear, let us continue with this question number. Let us solve this question number 9 and 10. Further, once we keep solving, so there is question number 9, there is 9. Question number 9, left hand side. Okay. left hand side. Okay, what we have to prove?
We have to prove that cos 3 pi by 2 plus x into cos of 2 pi plus x into cot of 3 pi by 2 minus x plus cot of 2 pi plus x, that gives equal to what? 1. Okay,
this left hand side, we have to prove that this left hand side is equal to right hand side, that is what? 1. Okay, let me check the equation once again. Pi plus or cot of, yeah, correct.
Okay, fine. Let us continue.
Left hand side equals to cos of 3 pi by 2 plus x into cos of 2 pi plus x. Okay, I'm writing here into cos of 3 pi by 2 plus 2 minus x plus cos 2 pi plus x. Okay?
Okay, fine. Now, again, we have to repeat one thing, that is what?
It is x and this is x dash. Y dash, this is y. So this is pi by 2, this is 0, and then this is what? Pi, and this is 3 pi by 2. Okay? 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2. Okay, fine. This is first quadrant, and this is second quadrant, and this is third, and this is fourth. Correct?
Okay, fine. As I told you that it is very important concept that we have discussed there in the one introduction part. Okay, if you have understood, so it is well and good. If not, please go back to the one introduction part. It is part 1 and part 2. Okay, it is very important concept. So without knowing this concept, so it's not possible to work out or solve the numerical problems of trigonometric function. Okay, this is very important rule.
So this is all positive, correct? And this is negative and positive terms. See, this is for negative, negative, and this is positive and negative. That means we are considering what? Cos x and what? Sin x. This x is nothing but this is x is an acute angle, right? So here, on this is the what? X-axis, and this is the y-axis, correct? On x-axis, the function, the trigonometric function does not change. It remains the same. Okay, on y-axis, okay, on y-axis the function changes. If the function changes, suppose if this cos will change, transform to what? Sine. Okay, then tan will transform to what? Cot. Okay, and then sec will transform to what? Cosec. Okay, cosec. Okay, okay, fine. Let us solve. So here cos of 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 plus x. What is 3 pi? Let us look at what is this 3 pi by 2. This is the 3 pi by 2. Up to here. So this part is what? This part is pi plus x. This part is what? 3 pi, less than 3 pi by 2. 3 pi minus x. And this part is what? 3 pi by 2. And this part is what? What? That is 3 pi by 2 plus x. This part, okay? This part. And this part is what? That is 3, what is that? 2 pi minus x. That means less than 360 degrees. So this is the place 2 pi. 2 pi means what? One complete rotation, okay? Pi means what? Half rotation. Pi equal to what? 180 degrees. 2 pi means what? 360 degree, correct? 360 degree. Okay, I'm rotating, okay, from here to here, okay, like this, okay, so it will have complete rotation. In complete rotation, the angle measure is what? 360 degree, and from this part, okay, this part and this part max equal to what? 180 degree, and this part also 180 degree, and altogether this 180 degree, and this part 180 degree, 180 plus 180, 360. Okay. If the function changes on y axis, okay, that means sine will turn into what? Cos will turn into sine. Tan will turn into what? Cot. Sec will turn into what? Turn into what? Turn into cosec. Okay, fine. Now this cos. Okay, cos will turn into what? Cos will turn into. So what is 3 pi by 2 plus x? This is the place of 3 pi by 2 plus x. Okay, so it is cos, right? Cos. Okay, then cos will turn into what? Sine. What is cos here? Cos is positive here. So it will be cos x. Okay, understood my dear? I hope you understood. Okay. Cos x. Secondly, plus 4, 2 pi plus x. Okay, this is the place 2 pi plus x. Okay, this is the, what is that? This is the what? Fourth quadrant, and this is the first quadrant. So this is 2 pi. Again, at every 2 pi, okay, at every interval, so what 2 pi? The function, what function? The trigonometric function starts repeating. Okay, starts repeating. So it will be what? Up to here 2 pi, that means it will be up to here, it will be 2 pi plus x like this. So it will be keep rotating again. Okay, starting from here to here, complete rotation. Again, starting from 0. Okay, so it will give plus x. Okay, so where it is? In the first quadrant. Okay, in the first quadrant, where it is lying? On x-axis. Right? On x-axis. Okay, what is this? Cos. Will it change? No, it will not change. Correct? It will not change. Fine. So it is cos on here. It is not. Okay. Oh, cos. Yeah. Hopefully I wrote the correct one, okay? I was calculating with this, so it was supposed to be this, right? So it will remain the same, right? Cos or sine? Cos or sine? Cos or sine, please? Okay. Tell me. What is this? It is not cos x. That means at this, okay, on y-axis, the function changes. Yes or no? Function changes. What is here? Cos is positive. And then what will be? So it will be turned into what? Cos to sine. Why sine will be positive? Sine was not supposed to be positive, because sine is what? Negative here. Right? Right? Because cos is transforming into what? Sine on y axis. Function changes. So that is why it will be cos will be turned into what? Sine x. Fine. And then here, come to this point. So 2 pi plus x. In which quadrant it is lying? So it is in first quadrant. Where it is now? On which axis? On x-axis. Okay? Here, at this x-axis, function does not change. Okay? What it is now? If function does not change, that means it will be cos x only. Right? Okay. So this will give 0. Okay? This will give 0. So this is why it will be cos x only. Okay? So next, so what is that? Cot 3 pi by 2 minus x. Okay, cot 3 pi by 2, this is the pi by 2. Correct? Function will change or not? Yes, function will change. Change into what? Function change, it is what? Positive. So cot here. Minus sine x. Minus cos x. So these two are negative. If these two are negative, then sine will be, tan will be, sorry, tan will be positive. So minus minus cancel. Cos will be, cos will also be positive. So minus cos x upon minus sine x. Correct? Cancel. So cos x. Fine. So since it is what? Cos, right? It is cos, so it is that the function will change. Change of function will take place, correct? Why this? Because it is lying where? On y axis. Okay? So this is function changes. Okay? If function changes, then it will, then that means this what is that? Cos will change into what? 10. Okay? 10. Now what about the sign? So it is positive. Both 10 and cos are positive, so 10 also will be positive. So it will be 10x. So it is plus, correct? Cot 2 pi plus x. Okay, here. Cot 2 pi plus x. Okay? So where it is lying? In which quadrant? In the first quadrant. Where? On which axis? On x axis. So on x axis, there is no any change. If there is no any change, that means it will be cot x only. Right? It will be cot x only.
I hope you understood this part. Okay, fine. So here you can write here in this place you can write 3 pi by 2 minus x also, or 10x also you can write directly, no problem. I have minimized this. Okay, this means this gives the value what? 0. This is also 0. Okay, 3 pi by 2 pi, 2 pi, so it will give 0 only, right? Okay. Okay, fine. Next, what is that? The sin x into cos x, that gives equal to 1, into 10x equal to 1. Let us take the, what is that? Cushion relation. Sin x upon cos x plus cot x will be cos x minus sin x. What is the need of, what is that, taking this question relation of 10x?
Because we must get equal to what? Okay, this one. Okay, otherwise it will not match. Okay, it does not match if we don't take this relation. Correct? There is no alternative way. Now, let us take the LCM. Sin x into cos x remains the same. And then let us take the LCM here. What is the LCM? So it will be sin x into cos x, correct? So to make equal to equalize this LCM, so what is the what is to be multiplied here? Of course, what is here? Sin cos x. So to get this, sin x is to be multiplied. So sin x into sin x into sin x. This is sin x, okay? Sin x plus, so to equalize with this, so since what we have to multiply with this? Sin x, we have to multiply by cos x. So cross multiplying like this, okay? On cross multiplying into even. So it will be cos x into cos x. Okay? Okay, fine. Then what we can do? This one and this one cancel. This one cancel, and this one cancel. Then sin x into sin x, sin square x. Plus cos is x into cos x, cos square x. So that we got the one identity that is we have learned in class 10, right? Sin square x plus cos square x. That means sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to what? 1. So sin square x plus cos square x equal to 1. That is the right hand side. Correct? I hope you understood. Okay. So my dear, before rubbing it, please pause the video and write it down, please. Okay, friends, next question.
The thing is that you have to keep revising the formulas or order identities and all. So when you keep doing practice, that means it will become more easier. Okay? So the more you don't practice, the more you become lazy, and then you will be forgetting, correct?
The more you practice, the more you gain, and the more you learn, and the more you become perfect, correct?
Okay, fine. Next, that is question number 10. Okay, I'm taking the left hand side directly. Left hand side equal to what? There is, okay, let me rearrange, okay, this is already in one formula, okay, let me write this one first, okay, this one first, and this one next. Okay, there is cos of what? n plus 1 into x cos of n plus 2 into x plus sine of n plus 1 into x into sine of what? Sine of n plus 2 into x. So what we have to prove? We have to prove that equals to what? Cos x. Let's see, it is already in one identity. It is already in one identity. In one identity, we have learned there is cos x, cos of x plus y, and then cos of x minus y. Okay, so what applies here? CDO rule. Okay, CDO rule. That means it will be what? So, cos x and then cos y, right? Then minus or plus? Minus sin x and then sin y, correct? So it will be what? Cos x, cos y plus it will be what? Sin x and sin y. So now this one is already there in this formula, right? So nothing is to be done, just let us put the value. Okay, let us put the value. So let us consider this as the what? X and this is y. Okay, and what is that? We have, as you can write, we have cos of x minus y gives equal what? That is cos x and then cos y plus sin x and then sin y. It is already in this form. Okay, this part is already in this form. Okay, now this equals what? Cos equals what? Cos this x part is what? N plus 1 into x. Okay, and then what is here? N plus 1 into x. Okay, let us write this bigger one first and smaller one next. Okay, this is 2 and this is 1. Okay, rearranging. Okay, so after that, what we can write? What we can write? Okay, then we can write cos of what? N plus 2 into x minus. What is there? Minus is there, so we have to put minus. So x equal to what? N plus 2 x. N plus 2 into x. And then y equal to what? N plus 1 into x. Correct? This is what? X and this is what? Y. Likewise, this is x, this part. Okay? And this part is what? Y. Okay? So if we put put in the formula in this, okay, then we get n plus 2 into x, n plus 2 times x minus n plus 1 times x. Okay, so cos of it will be what? N into x, nx, 2 into x, 2x, minus n into x, nx, minus into plus, minus, so it will be x, right? Is there something that will cancel? Yes, it will cancel, nx, nx, okay? Cos of what? 2x minus x, right? That means cos 2x minus x, that is x. So this is the right answer, this is the our answer, okay? Fine. Okay, my dear, before loving it, please pause the video and write it down, please.